Hey everybody and welcome back to another Darkfall video. So today I want to share with you the update for the shader library add-on version 1.6. So let's go ahead and take a look. Now if we press N, go to the shader library tab. So we have some new additions to the add-on and I've also done some improvements under the hood. So it now works in future versions of Blender. I'm still working on 2.9, but anything below 2.9 this add-on will now work. So you do have the stylized section. So yeah, we have three new additions. Let me just go ahead and open these up. So we first have a basic brick material. So let's go ahead and select the default cube, hit the brick material, and we don't see anything since we're not in rendered view. So let's change this to rendered. By the way, I'm using cycles, but it also works in Eevee. So might as well go ahead and change it to Eevee. And there we go. So what I'm gonna do is just press tab to go into edit mode, press U and just cube projection. See if that fixes it, and it does. So now we have this perfectly unwrapped cube. And again, you can play around with these materials if you just want to open this up. Change this to the shader editor. Press N, get rid of the sidebar here. So we can see this is the material. Let's go ahead and check a preview. And we can play around with things like the bump or the brick texture itself, make things bigger and smaller. It's up to you. We can also play around with a grungy color. We have two colors. First, the main color here. Change this to any color you want, and I'm mixing that with a noise texture, so we could play around with the scale. Could also make it darker, make it a different color, do whatever you want. So yeah, it's a very basic brick texture. If you want to use that, go ahead and use that. So with this material, and in fact all of these materials, I will be updating them in the next version to be a little bit better. So for example, when we press the button, it'll actually give us an option for the color and maybe the size and things like that. So same thing for the Sci-fi Gold. Let's go ahead and add another object. I'm going to move this out of the way. Shift A, go to mesh. Let's add in a UV sphere. It's a bit blocky right now. So I'm going to use the search operator, which for me is spacebar, but for you it could be F3 depending on your key configuration. And then I'm going to type smooth and let's shade smooth. So let's go ahead and add a Sci-fi Gold material. See, we get this pretty cool sci-fi material. I don't know if you guys would use this quite a lot, and again in the next version I'll probably make this better by giving us options to choose the color and choose the scale and things. And again, you can play around with this material if you want. The best thing to play around with would be this noise texture here. Play around with the scale, detail and distortion and get loads of really interesting cool looks depending on what you're going for. For the color, you'd go up here to the RGB, so that's the Sci-fi Gold. And then the last addition is this clouds material, which you might have already seen in a previous tutorial, the project cloud. There'll be a link up here if you want to go ahead and check that out. But it's a pretty simple material. If we just shift A, we could add a cube. Let's just move this over a little bit and then scale it up. And then if we hit clouds, it'll change it to this cloud material. Now, since we've scaled it up, the scaling is a bit messed up. So shift A, apply that scale, and there we go. And if you want, you can play around with this material. It's very basic, and I will be improving it in the next version. I want to make it a little bit more complex. But if you want, you can improve this by adding some lights. If we grab this light and just move it down, you see it looks a little bit better already. Depending on where you put the camera angle, if you put it straight on, it doesn't look that great. But again, if you check out the project cloud, you'll see how we used it in that video. But again, we can make some adjustments to this, play around with the color ramp. So we can make it more faded or a bit more thicker. We just open this up. So we could actually take the factor from this noise texture and plug it into the emission strength, which would give us overblown clouds. So we'd need a color ramp. Might as well duplicate this one, Shift D. Drop it onto this string and let's play around with this. Something like that. So you get the idea. You can play around with it, you can play with the scale, make it bigger or smaller. It's entirely up to you. But yeah, that's the three new additions to this shader library. And again, some work was done under the hood just to make it work in future versions. So thanks to you guys for letting me know that it doesn't work in future versions, because as you guys might already know, I'm working with version 2.8. so it's great when you guys let me know when things don't work and I can actually get to work on it. And it's a little tricky since we're all using different versions of Blender. So not that long ago, actually, I created a poll asking what versions of Blender you guys are using if we go to the Facebook group. So thanks to you guys who got involved and let me know what version of Blender you're using. And it, again, it's a mixed bag. So yeah, if you can let me know what version of Blender you guys are using in the comments below, it really does help me out when I'm creating tutorials or developing an add-on. So if you guys could let me know, I'd definitely appreciate that. So yeah, if you want to download version 1.6 of the add-on, there'll be a link in the description below. Go ahead and click that. It'll take you to the blog post. So then if we scroll down, we'll see this is the tutorial from last time. If you want to watch it, go ahead and click this. If you want to download the script, go ahead and click here and you can check out the script, or if you want, just go ahead and download it. So I hope you find this update helpful and hopefully you're enjoying this add-on. Be sure to hit that like button. And as always, thanks for watching.